On the 3,000. Boxer of Great Britain is a good one. So is Dorio. As you see the lineup, Debbie Scott and Britt McRoberts of Canada. Ruth Wysocki of the United States is the only American to have qualified Marty LaQuarrie for this race. Diana Richburg and Missy Keene, who got into the Olympics as the alternate when Mary decided she wasn't going to run, did not qualify. And how do you see this one shaping up?
Well, it's interesting because we have the two gold medalists from the 800 meters and the 3,000 meters meeting really halfway in this race. The gold medalist from the 800 meters, Malenta, is running twice as far, and she's running against Puika, who won the 3,000 meters, which is, you know, she is now running half her distance. So that'll be an interesting matchup. Ruth Wysocki, the surprise in the American women's distance corps this year. She improved 12 seconds in the trials to beat Mary Decker by a small margin in the 1500 meters. She's already run the 800 meters here as we look at 314 Malenta. Well, that was Loven, her teammate. So the Romanians are strong in this. The British are good. Christina Boxer has run 4 minutes, much the same as Wysocki. As I said, Wysocki was in the 800 meters, did not medal, ran a good time, but somewhat faded in the stretch. So we'll see. They canceled one round in the 1500, so that was to Ruth's advantage. She had a chance to recover from what might have been considered by her a little bit of a disappointing race.
So the strategy in this race sends Roswitha Geerdes of West Germany out toward the front. She's number 122 and 314, Fiha Lovien, going very wide here in the first turn on the outside. That's Christina Boxer maintaining her position on the inside, the lady from Great Britain, the 1982 British Commonwealth champion. World mark is 352.47, Olympic record 356.56 in the women's 1500 meters.
Gabriella Dorio, the Italian, right there in the blue, 226. I expected her to get the lead, but she wasn't able to get out at the start. She was in the middle of the pack. She has gracefully worked herself out of the pack without getting stepped on and is now moving up and may go for the lead. Not on the turn. She's probably too smart for that, but maybe down the next backstretch when she hears the time yelled, she will move up and go for the lead.
Less than three laps remaining. Christina Boxer of Great Britain out in front. Going right with her is the lady from West Germany. Off her right shoulder, Roswitha Geerdes. Christine Benning of Great Britain is running third, 106.14, the first split.
It's a good pace for an Olympic final. The pace is fairly honest, so it's going to be a true test of who is the best athlete and not just the best sprinter. Ruth Wysocki in the back of the screen there, the USA, is running very smart. She's a tall woman with long legs and a back kick, so she doesn't want to get in by the rail and mix it up and run the problem. Run the problem of getting stepped on, so she's running the extra yards to try and avoid that problem.
And still, as you say, she went to the outside and still got into some difficulty. And fresh in everybody's mind, obviously, this race is what happened to Mary Decker last night, and that's Dorio moving up into second position. So that whole field is right there with two laps to go.
And they have let Christine Boxer of the United States, of Great Britain, set the pace. Dorio, another one who will probably try and make a move with about 600 yards to go to try and get away from Doina Malenta of Romania. And as you see, the striking blonde in the middle of the pack, Puika, who won the 3,000 meters, she would have to start moving out now and get up with the leaders because I don't know that she'll be able to run with them in the stretch. Wysocki, 405, USA, in very good position, but she's run an awful lot of extra yards.
214.6, time at 800 meters with Gabriela Dorio of Italy in first place, and that is Doina Malenta of Romania in second position. She is the lady who won the 800. And there is Ruth Wysocki keeping contact.
Dorio sensed the pace slow down and she moved right from the front. In the Olympics, you cannot hesitate when you know the race is starting to change rapidly and it's moving away from your best race. You've got to be decisive and move quickly.
And it's Dorio starting to stretch it out now. Doina Malenta, number 315, and Cuica there, the blonde lady in yellow and blue from Romania. She too trying to double. So the two Romanians both trying to double with Dorio still out in front, and Christina Boxer in third position, still very much in the race.
Look at the blonde.
Look at Kulika in
seventh. She dropped back now to get around on the outside, and I think she's going to make a charge. Malenta now leading.
It's Doina Malenta who has the lead. Looks like there might have been some contact there as they go into the shadows. Dorio is in second place. And Waisaki just does not have it. Ruth is well back in the pack. It's Dorio trying to hold on with Malenta right there. Gabriella Dorio of Italy, fourth in the 800 meters. She appears to have enough to hold on to win it. Gabriella Dorio heading toward the finish line. And Gabriella Dorio is the winner at 1,500 meters. Doina Malenta winds up in second position. And Kulika, I believe, gets third. She does win the bronze medal. So a couple of medals for both of the Romanians as Dorio winds up taking the gold and Ruth Waisaki crosses the line in eighth place.
And what an exciting finish. I remember when she was 16 years old and she took over the mantle from Paola Pulci, who was a great Italian woman's 1,500 meters. She took it over. She was a 16-year-old superstar on the European circuit. She has been around now, at least 14 years, always in there in the big races, but never winning the big one. And she beat a very good field, handling the two Romanians in the stretch and also leading for the last 600 meters. It must be a very satisfying victory.